39.
The earliest period of my childhood coincided precisely with the earliest years of the worldwide Great Depression. But out of the incredible poverty of a childhood in the ghetto, I do have the richness of some precious memories, which I owe to the fact that I was part of a stable, close and devoted family. Simon's Tom, depicted behind me, where I was born and where we lived, was a naval town, the South Atlantic base of the British Royal Navy. It had, and still has, a character all of its own. Visitors often comment on its Englishness, and this I find interesting. But as a child living there, what created a strong impression on me was the fact that throughout its history, it has seen the movement of many people, all kinds, indigenous locals, as well as outsiders, foreigners, arriving from and departing to other areas of the world, north, south, east, and west. Taking part last year in the Genographic Project in sub-Saharan Africa, like all participants, local and former local residents of Simon's Town, I had to provide the team with a saliva sample for research purposes. In due course, receiving my results, I was astonished to find that in my ancestry are predecessors whose origins lie not only in the continent of Africa, but also in Siberia, the Americas, East and Southeast Asia, the Middle East, Europe and India. How amazing this complexity, when just like other human beings, I look the uncomplicated way I do. Simon's Town being a naval town, every day the sea washes into my consciousness. Local fishermen and their boats and sailors and their ships emphasize the fact of the invisible causes of voyages are undertaken this way and that way, on the South Atlantic and other oceans of the world. In childhood, I looked forward to the family outings to relatives living in various parts of the Western Cape. One of my father's elderly aunts was Auntie Johanna, whose particular quirk was wearing a man's hat to shield her head from the heat of summer. The other unusual thing about Auntie Johanna was her husband, Uncle Charles. In actual fact, Henry Charles spoke with a quote-unquote funny accent, even though he looked like one of us. I wondered about him. Many years later, when I asked about Uncle Charles, my dad told me, Uncle Charles came from Barbados. Today, when I am an elderly person, it pains me that my history is so fragmented. I would love to have known Uncle Charles' story, how he came to be where he became destined to be related to me. I will never know, sadly. Now, all that left of this for that old uncle is the faded memory of his accent, with its origins on an island unknown to me, except by its position on the map. Thousands of miles lay between the reality of that island and their own existence. On Tuesday, 7th of December, 1954, I was 25 years old at the time, I bought an American paperback book titled New World Writing, Fourth Mentor Selection. Today, in 2009, the volume, and that after all these years, with pages loose and held together, discolored with tape and time and affection, still holds its place in my library. I have read this book over and over and over, because it contains a wealth of fiction, non-fiction, poetry, and artwork by a collection of creative men and women of the wide world. Included in this amazing anthology is a work, an excerpt from a novel, In the Castle of My Skin, by a young Barbadian writer named George Lamming. It was while reading the Lamming work that I found myself thinking, but all of it is so familiar, the characters, their responses to each other, presence, the setting, the colours projected into one's consciousness, all of it as if out of my own life. I wondered about George Lamming's Barbados, the island from which my father and uncle Henry Charles came at some unknown date in my family's historical background. I wondered if when Uncle Charles arrived in South Africa, he seemed strange and familiar to people living here. I wonder when viewers become acquainted with me by way of my exhibition, if they might see me as strange and familiar too. It will please me greatly if they do. I would like visitors to this exhibition to regard the collection as a sample of a much larger output of a fairly long art career. In this way, I hope you of the African diaspora will enjoy the experience of becoming acquainted with this distant member of your